Okay. So outcome. So here I just describe how you write down the outcome. It may be a course level outcome, it may be a module level outcome, it may be a unit level outcome. Any outcome when you write down, it must be specific, measurable and achievable. So that students or learners should able to do after receiving the instruction or after going through the material. You have already learned that any outcome when it written using ISD principle, it must have three components: performance component, condition component and criteria component. Performance component provide what learner will able to do. Condition component provide what kind of things will be given to the learner under what condition. So, condition component actually related to the specificity. So, it provides specific part. Then criteria component. Criteria component, unless you provide the criteria component, maybe outcome is not achievable. So, if the outcome complexity is varies, so how much complex outcome is desirable for this document? For example, suppose Archimedes principle. If I write for class 11 level, if I write for physics honors, if I write for MSc, what will vary? Cognitive level and complexity both will vary. Sometimes cognitive level may be same, but complexity will vary. Maybe you can say, this school class 8 student doesn't have that capacity. So, reduce the complexity level, do not change the cognitive level. If I say, I am developing a material for mathematics, differential equation, no, I said, no, no, this document, this material for very preliminary level, it does not mean that those students only know what is differential equation and what describe it. Define it, not that. They have to solve the differential equation, but the complexity may be very low, maybe up to second order or maybe up to first order differential equation. So, when I say skill, the content not only designed for information, if it is only designed for information, content, lot of material is available. What is the difference between your content and that material available? So, instead of information only, you have to introduce skill part providing outcome. So, when you write down the outcome, whether it is module level, whether it is unit level, whether it is course level, it must be specific, measurable, achievable. Performance component must be measurable and that has to be developed by the learner. Condition component specify what kind of condition, means for what they have to perform, and criteria component specify how much complexity they have to solve. So, you have to think on that way when you write down the outcome. Okay. For example, this course outcome example I am giving. Suppose I am developing a short course on room acoustics. So, 4 to 5 week duration course, room acoustics. So, what I am dealing with? I am dealing with certain parameters. So, what is the main outcome from that course? At the end of this document, what learner has to solve, learner has to develop? Given the specification of an acoustic room, given the specification of an acoustic room, room may be large room or small room acoustic, determine the reverberation time, mean free path, number of reflection per second, room nodes, minimum volume for large room acoustic. So, what skill they have to develop? If I provide the room specification of an acoustic room, they should able to calculate those parameters from that specification. But the second outcome, given the specification of an auditorium or studio requirement. So, suppose I said I require a auditorium this much capacity, this much of reverberation time, and this is the civil drawing I given to them. What skill they should have? They should able to list out the acoustical requirement and design the acoustic part of the auditorium. I am not saying they will design the auditorium. So, their job is to design the acoustic part of the auditorium. Next, determine the sound reflection, transmission, absorption coefficient for a given acoustic source and condition. If you see, all the outcomes are specific, measurable, and achievable within that course. So, I said my course is 3 to 4 week course on only on room acoustics. So, I have only 2 to 3 outcome, I have written down 3 outcome. Okay. So, once I develop the course outcome, then I have to develop the course level problem. So, suppose for this outcome I want to design a problem. So, what is the outcome? Determine the sound reflection, transmission, absorption coefficient for a given acoustic source and condition. So, what problem I have given? Plane wave in a water of 100 Pascal effective RMS pressure are incident normally on a sand bottom. The sand bottom is characterized by like this, where speed of sound is this and density is this. Calculate the effective pressure of the wave, of the reflected wave, sorry, there is a mistake, reflected wave, wave reflected back into water, and the effective pressure of wave transmitted into the sand. So, I never ask define sound transmission, because outcome is not for define. Outcome is determine the sound reflection and transmission coefficient. So, as per your outcome whatever you written, your problem must be related to that outcome. Today you have seen many books written outcome in the beginning, then the chapter, end of the chapter, there is a lot of questions, lot of assignment problems are there, but none of the problem related to the outcome. What I am saying, outcome must be related to the problem. So, learner know if I able to solve this problem, I have achieved this outcome. So, I have a 3 outcome at the beginning. So, at least 3 course level problem I should provide. It may be possible one problem related to the more than one outcome, it may be possible. So, I give a problem which can related to the 2 outcome of the given 3, or I give a problem which can related to the all 3 outcome whatever I have given. Good. I can say if you are able to solve this problem, you achieve all 3 outcomes. So, not only single problem, I can give multiple problem, I can give 2, 3, 4, but at least one problem must be there for every outcome. So, now the content design, that part is separate. I am dealing with that target part and how a learner will test whether he achieved that learning outcomes or not. Okay. So, this way you have to write down the course outcome and course level problem, and this is the example of course outcome and course level problem. When you write down the course overview, write only one paragraph on coverage of your material, but one paragraph must be written how you can motivate the learner. Means, what kind of real life problem related to those skill. So, suppose I writing this room acoustic, I can say this skill will allow you to design the auditorium or work as a consultant to the architecture people for acoustic design. So, then people related, okay, this material is very good. If I read this material, I should acquire this skill, and this will give me this kind of facility, this to solve this kind of real world problem. Then your material will enrich, learner will engage, because learner know I have to achieve this. Unless I achieve this, I cannot say I have completed this course. So, course here, any e-content is not only for information, it is included the skill and attitude of 21st century requirement. Okay? So, next class I will talk about, or next video I will talk about the module outcome, module overview and unit outcome, unit overview, all those things. Okay? Thank you.